Hi, welcome back to Love English. You know, in our day-to-day lives, we have desires ranging from small to big. And one turn phrase we use often to express these desires is I want. I want කියන phrase එක අපි හැමතිස්සම use කරනවා අපි කැමති දේවල් එහෙම නැත්නම් අපිට ඕන දේවල් ගැන කියන්න. I want this, I want that, I want to do this, likewise. So just to spice up life, here are some better options or better expressions you can use to talk about your desires. Phrase number one, I am dying. I am dying කියන phrase එක ඔයගලන්ට use කරන්න පුළුවන් ඔයගොල්ලෝ මොන හරි දෙයකට තදින්ම කැමති එහෙම නැත්නම් ඔයාට මොන හරි දෙයක් තදින්ම ඕනේ කියන එක ගැන කියන්න. You can use this phrase to mean that you badly want something or just to highlight that you have a burning desire for something. For example, we can say I am dying for a vacation. I am dying for some pizza, which means that you badly crave pizza. ඒ කියන්නේ ඔයාට පීසා එකක් කන්නම ඕනේ. ඒ වගේ තද ආසාවක් එමු නැත්තම් තදින්ම ඔයාට ඕන කරන දෙයක් විස්තර කරන්න ඔයාට මේ I am dying for කියන එක use කරන්න පුළුවන්. And we can use this even with the preposition to and end up saying I am dying to, which in turn you can use for some example. I am dying to go out with him. I am dying to go out with him. I am dying to work out. I am dying to work out. I am dying to කියන phrase එකෙන් කියන්නේ අර විදිහටම ඔයාට තදින්ම දෙයක් මොන හරි කරන්න ඕනේ. එහෙම නැත්නම් ඔයාට තදින්ම මොන හරි දෙයක් ඕනේ කියන එක තමයි I am dying to කියන phrase එකෙන් කියන්නේ. So this is a phrase you can use when you are expressing your desires. And let's move to the phrase number 2. දෙවෙනි එක තමයි I am in the mood for. I am in the mood for. A very casual and a handy phrase you can use to tell that you want something. I am in the mood for, especially in a friendly conversation or in a kind of relaxed conversation. You can say, I am in the mood for a run. I am in the mood for a show, which means that you want to go for a show. Okay? So I am in the mood කියන කෙනුත් අපි කියන්නේ අපිට මොන හරි දෙයක් කරන්න ඕනේ කියන එක. අර අපි සිංහලෙන් කියන්නේ අපි නිකන් මෙන්න මෙහෙම දෙයක් කරන මූඩ් එකේ ඉන්නේ කියලා. අන්න ඒ වෙලාවට තමයි අපි මේ I am in the mood කියන phrase එක use කරන්නේ. And here the tone is very casual and relaxed. අපි හැමතිස්සෙම relax tone එකකින් තමයි මේ phrase එක කියන්නේ. ඒ වගේම relax situations වලදී තමයි අපි මේ phrase එක use කරන්නේ. And the phrase number 3. Number 3 is I feel like. I feel like a very simple yet nice way of telling what you want. Remember, in casual conversations, simple is sometimes the best. අපි simple වෙන තරමට තමයි අපේ conversation එක ලස්සන වෙන්නේ. So this phrase is all about simplicity. මේ phrase එක හරිම simple. I feel like කියන phrase එක. You can say I feel like eating. I feel like visiting my friends. I feel like, and I would say it's universal phrase, as in you can use this phrase anywhere. What only matter ko me I feel like kiyana phrase ekak use karanna pulang. Harima simple me phrase ekak. And let's move on to the next one. Next one is I do with. We can say I could do with, or as we can say I really do with. Meken kiyanne tapita mona hari deyak hone kiyana eka. So this is another way of expressing your desire. And you can say, I really do with a cup of tea. I really do with a cup of tea, which means that you want a tea or you would like to have a tea. I really do with a cup of tea. Or as you can say, I could do with a nice cool drink. I could do with a nice cool drink. May I could do with, I really do with, ඔයාට මොන හරි දෙයක් ඕනේ කියලා කියන්න. And there's another way of using this phrase, that is when you want more of something or when you want another round of something. ඔයාට තව මොන, ඒ කියන්නේ එකම දේ තව ඕනේ කියන්න. එහෙම නැත්නම් ඔයාට තව රවුන්ඩ් එකක් ඕනේ කියනත් ඔයා මේ ෆ්‍රේස් එක යූස් කරනවා. I could really do with කියන ෆ්‍රේස් එක ඔයා යූස් කරනවා. For example, we can say if you want more tea, you can say I could really do with another cup of tea. I could really do with another cup of tea. එකන මට තව ටී එකක් බිව් එක කියන එක තමයි එකෙන් කියන්නේ. I could really do with another cup of tea. So from this sentence you say that you can go for another round of tea. If you want more of something or another round of something, you can use this phrase. I could really do with another and tell what you want. I could really do with another. And let's move on to the last one. The final one, fifth one, that is I am up. I am up. A very go with the flow of expressing your desires. I am up. And we can say I am up for a run. I am up for a hangout. If you say I am up for a hangout, that means that you are happy to hang out with your friends. Okay? Here you are mentioning about your desire, but the desire is not so strong. Which means that you want something, but not strongly or passionately. Maybe kind of a light desire. Okay? So you can say I'm up. I'm up for a run. I'm up for a show. I'm up for a vacation. I'm up. And sometimes if you say I'm up, that means that you can be included. Or samahara velawata I am up kiyana eka kiwwama eken mean wenne oyawa monahari deekata include karaganna puluwan kiyana eka. Oyawa include karaganna puluwan kiyana eka thamai eken kiyanne. Just assume that if somebody suggests on a trip, if you say I'm up, that means you can be included. Or your friends can count you in. ඔයා සමහරට කවුරු හරි කෙනෙක් ට්‍රිප් එකක් යමුද කියලා ඇහුවම ඔයා කිව්වොත් I am up කියලා එතනින් කියන්නේ ඔයා ඒකට okay කියලා that you are okay with joining the trip. ඔයා ඒකට okay එහෙම නැත්නම් ඔයාව ඒ ට්‍රිප් එකට යන කෙනෙක් හැටියට කවුන්ට් කරගන්න පුළුවන් කියන එක තමයි ඔයා I am up කියන එකෙන් කියන්නේ. එතකොට I am up කියනක යූස් කරනවා සාමාන්‍යයෙන් ඔයාට මූඩ් එකක් තියෙනවා එහෙම නැත්නම් ඔයා දෙයක් කරන්න කැමති කියන එක කියන්නේ ඒ වගේම එහෙම නැත්නම් ඔයාව කවුන්ට් කරගන්න පුළුවන් කියන එකටත් ඔයා I'm up කියන ෆ්‍රේස් එක යූස් කරනවා. And another thing, if you want you can switch this word up to down and say I'm down for. I'm down for, which gives out the same idea. You can say I'm down for a run. I'm down for a run. Which gives the same idea as that you are up for a run. I'm down for a run kiwat. I am up for a run kiwat. ඒ දෙකෙම එන්නේ එකම meaning එකක්. So you can use either I'm up or I'm down. මේ phrases දෙකෙන් ඕනම එකක් වාට use කරන්න පුළුවන්. Well, so here are some of the many expressions you can use to add a little variety in your day-to-day conversations and help others better understand about your desires. So I hope you start using some of these in order to add more color to your conversation. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did so, please give it a thumbs up and also please subscribe to our channel and don't forget to hit the notification bell to never miss our videos. And I'm dying to be back for another new lesson the next day and have a great day. Bye bye.